If you're looking to record a podcast remotely and you already have a Zoom subscription or a Zoom account, you might be wondering, can I just use Zoom for recording remote guests for my podcast? Or maybe your co-host lives in a different city. And the answer is yes, Zoom can be good for podcast recording. In this video, I'm going to show you some basic tips and settings for getting the most out of Zoom when you're recording podcasts. First step is you're going to need a good microphone. You don't want to use your built-in computer microphone. And because you don't want the sound from your speakers to bleed into the recording, you're going to want to use some headphones while you're recording the podcast. So here I am in Zoom. And the first thing I want to do is go up to the settings. And we're going to start with audio. Now, as you can see, I've got this microphone running into an audio interface here. We can have it automatically adjust the microphone volume, or if you want more control, you can uncheck that and just use your microphone or your sound interface's settings. The other thing you might want to experiment with is this right here. If you have a really good recording environment where it's quiet, maybe you're recording in a closet surrounded by clothes, or you have a studio or office with soundproofing, you can choose this here, original sound for musicians. And then I would also uncheck echo cancellation, because if you're using headphones and a microphone, you won't need their built-in echo cancellation. So you can just leave all of these checkboxes unchecked, but just have original sound for musicians checked. If you do have a lot of background noise, you might want to try Zoom optimized audio, but for the best quality, it's better to have a soundproof room, a good microphone, headphones, and choose original sound. So that's the first setting you want to change. The other thing you're going to want to change is go to the recording area here, and you're going to choose record a separate audio file for each participant. So we're going to check that right there. All right, so now that I've got those two settings ready to go, I'm going to create a new meeting, and then I'll just join it with my phone so that I have someone else on the call. So first thing, I'm going to make sure I have the right microphone selected. You might also choose to record video if you want to export clips to YouTube or publish little teasers on Instagram or Twitter. And let me just invite, in this case, myself. All right, so now I've got myself here as the guest in a real recording situation. It'd be a real person somewhere else. And I'm just going to click the record button down here in Zoom to start the recording. So if I'm ready to start the interview, I'll click record. You can record to the cloud or onto this computer. I'll just record onto the cloud. So now I could have an interview with myself and say, hey, Justin, what do you think about this topic? And then over here I could go, well, I think that it's outrageous. And then I could ask a few more questions like, how's the weather where you're at? And I could say, well, it's sunny and beautiful. And we could go back and forth until the podcast is done being recorded. At the end of the recording, I'm going to go up here and I'm going to click stop record. I'm going to say, oh, and then I'm going to say goodbye to my guest. Goodbye, see you later. And they're going to hang up. And now it's just me back in the studio by myself. I'm going to end this call. And now I've just gotten a message from Zoom that the cloud recording is available. So I'm going to click on this, log into Zoom, and I'm going to download this recording. And after I download those files, I'll have a separate audio track for each speaker, and then I'll be able to edit those as separate audio tracks, which is really important. For example, I may want to increase the volume on this one here, maybe normalize both of them, be able to edit the tracks separately, and this allows me to do that. Once I'm done editing the audio files, I'm going to export it as a single audio file. And then to publish this as a podcast episode, I'll head over to my podcast hosting provider. In this case, it's Transistor. Click new episode. Amazing interview. And then I'll just upload that episode I just edited from Zoom. And then I can save and publish it, and it will get sent out to all of my subscribers, and people will be able to find it on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google Podcasts, wherever I'm distributing my show. So is Zoom good for podcast recording? As long as you change those settings I mentioned earlier, and as long as both guests have a microphone, headphones are connected through their computer is best. So have each person with a microphone plugged into their computer with headphones connecting to Zoom. You'll have really great recording, and it's a great way to get those separate audio tracks for podcast editing, and then you can just publish the way you normally would. Hopefully that's helpful. If you'd like to try out Transistor for your podcast hosting, you can head over to transistor.fm and click that 14-day free trial button. You can even bring in an existing podcast if you're hosted somewhere else.